The time is 6 p.m. and we're coming together to for our regularly scheduled council meeting. A very exciting meeting for some new council members to be installed. We begin our meetings with an invocation and pledge of allegiance to our country. So if it's convenient, please rise.
Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you again for the day. Thank you, Father, for all your blessings. Thank you, Father, for just a time like this. Lord, as we're here for a city council meeting, but Father, as Mayor Roberts said, just an exciting time. And Father, thank you for the city council. Thank you for the members going out, and Father, thank you for those that are coming in. And Father, just through this meeting, may your spirit lead and guide. I pray this in Jesus' name.
Thank you, sir.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. You may be seated. Without calling out too many names and maybe forgetting someone and hurting feelings, I won't do that. But I will say each and every one of you, thank you for coming out. This is a very exciting time. I'm excited for what lays ahead in my life, and I know that those coming in are excited as well. We have the honor of having elected the first woman to be mayor in the city of Crockett, and we're excited about that. At this point, we'll move on to item number 3, and that is comments from the audience or council. And nothing has been laid on the desk for members of the audience to speak. Council, is there anyone who... Yes?
Sure. Thank you.
Sure.
Mr. Mayor, I just want to take this opportunity to say thank you to some people who helped us put Crockett on the map again with our Davy Crockett days. The Crockett Area Chamber of Commerce couldn't do what it does without its membership and also without those who play the parts behind the scenes. And tonight I just want to thank some of those tireless heroes who step up every time we say, you know, I think we need to do this or that. And I want to tell you that our first annual Davy Crockett Festival, and the reason it says annual is because we actually had one last year, but it was up on the sidewalks. And we actually had 4 vehicles in our car show, thanks to Mr. Bruner. And we knew it had better bones than that. And so we turned it into a festival. And in doing that, we were able to close off the square, and we were able to bring people into Crockett, which is our mission with the Crockett Area Chamber of Commerce. And we just want to thank all of you who participated in any way. This year we had 22 vehicles, and we also, if you'll remember, Diane, you started Christmas in Crockett 36 years ago with 25 vendors. We had over 50. So I think for the first time out as a festival on the square, it was a rousing success. I even heard from the merchants that they had a big day, just like they do when we have Christmas in Crockett. And that's what it's all about, bringing people in and sharing what we have in Crockett. So thank you very much for all that you did to help us be successful in this event. I want to start by thanking the people who actually made it possible. If it hadn't been for paperwork, if it hadn't been for barricades and trash receptacles, and all of their knowledge. Mitzi and John, would you come down and represent the city of Crockett? On behalf of the Crockett Area Chamber, we'd like to give you $1 million, but this will just have to be. Thank you. The next set of unsung heroes, the fire department. Jason Frizzell, would you come forward and accept a little token of our appreciation? When that big truck pulls up, everybody stands up and takes notice. And we want to thank them. They never say, well, what do you want me to do? They're just there. And we appreciate it so much, Christmas in Crockett, at any time. So if you will share that with the men. Thank you. And then the next unsung heroes, Chief Buddy Cross, and the men of the Crockett Police Department, and the women. So I want y'all to come forward, all of you that are standing back there. Come on.
Good looking bunch.
It's a wonderful good looking bunch. You bet it is. Chief, I want to thank you so much. You stepped up every time we put out the call. We even had a fun run one time, and we were trying to map it off and scale it down. And, you know, I do pretty good with a big fat pencil and a big chief tablet. And the next thing I know, here came Officer Smith in, and he had the whole map, and it was laminated. The police department had measured it out, tireless runs up and down the streets, measuring to see what it would be. That's what your Crockett Police Department does for you, unsung heroes. And this is just our way of acknowledging that and saying thank you so very much and share.
Thank you, Miss Julie. I love our little town of Crockett, Texas.
Yes.
And I hope you do too.
Yes.
We have some of the finest people you will find anywhere. And I would ask you, and I've said this publicly, and I plead with you, when you're speaking of Crockett, speak well of Crockett.
Amen.
Every town has its problems. Every town. No matter where you go, outside of the borders of our country, they also have problems. Speak well of our town. Accentuate the positives.
Absolutely.
I won't dwell on that, but we have a nice audience here tonight, and I hope that you will consider that the next time you find yourself in a conversation with someone who maybe does not speak well of Crockett, call them out. It's a very uncomfortable thing to do, but I found myself doing it. I'll move on. Are there any other comments from City Council? All right, we'll move on to item number 4, the canvassing of the election returns. I have here various packets, and what we'll do is individually we'll look at these, and we'll pass on those that we have not seen, if I said that correctly. My instructions are very clear, and I will open them. Okay, Council, we now canvass the votes. Those in favor of accepting the canvass votes, please raise your hands. All right, none opposed. Passes 5-0. Thank you, Council. I'm sorry. Yeah, jumped the gun. I need a motion in order to accept the canvass votes.
I'd like to make a motion to accept the canvass votes.
Do we have a second? Is there any discussion? Those in favor, please raise your hand. 5-0. Thank you, Council. My apologies. I'm ready to get out of the game.
At this time, I'll administer the
oath of office to the new mayor and two new incoming council members. What we'll do is probably move this podium back a little bit, and I'll just call up each council member at a time, and then the mayor. And when you're finished with your oath of office, you can step aside and we can all be together in front of us. Either separately or all together. First of all, I'd like to call Michael Calvert, Councilman Precinct 1. Raise your right hand and repeat after me, okay? I, Michael Butch Calvert.
I, Michael Butch Calvert.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully execute the duties of the office of.
That I will faithfully execute the duties of the office of.
Councilmember, City of Crockett.
Councilmember, City of Crockett.
Of the state of Texas.
Of the state of Texas.
And will to the best of my ability.
And will to the best of my ability.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
The Constitution and laws of the United States and of this state.
Constitution and laws of the.
Of the United States.
The United States.
And of this state.
And of this state.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Let me get him there, you can sign that and hand it to me.
Yes. Councilman, I'd like to present you with your certificate. Congratulations.
Appreciate it.
Secondly, I'd like to call Councilman Darrell J. Jones, Councilman Precinct 2. Raise your right hand and repeat after me. I, Darrell J. Jones.
I, Darrell J. Jones.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully execute.
I will faithfully execute.
The duties of the office of.
The duties of the office of.
Councilmember, City of Crockett.
Councilmember, City of Crockett.
Of the state of Texas.
Of the state of Texas.
And will to the best of my ability.
And will to the best of my ability.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
And of this state.
And of this state.
So help me God.
So help me God.
You sign that and hand it back to me when we get up there. Councilman. Congratulations.
All right.
Last of all, I'd like to call Ms. Julie Plons, Mayor. Raise your right hand, please, and repeat after me. I, Johnny K. Plons.
I, Johnny K. Plons.
Do solemnly swear.
Do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully execute.
That I will faithfully execute.
The duties of the office.
The duties of the office.
Of Mayor, City of Crockett.
The Mayor, City of Crockett.
Of the state of Texas.
Of the state of Texas.
And will to the best of my ability.
And will to the best of my ability.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
The Constitution and laws of the United States.
The Constitution and the laws of the United States.
And of this state.
And of this state.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Madam Mayor, it's my pleasure to present to you your certificate. I would like us to welcome them into their new office.
And at this time, you know, each sink starts on that end, precinct 1 and 2, and you will replace the exiting council members.
Okay.
And the mayor.
Thank you. for item number six on the agenda. It is the Fire Department Monthly Activity and Status Report for April 2017.
Mayor, council members. All right, for the month of April, the fire department had 39 total calls. None of those 39, 30 of them was in the city, 8 of them in the county. There was no structured fires in either one of them. We have a total manpower of 17, and y'all should have a report in front of you that's broke down further in detail. If I have any questions, I'll answer them for you.
Number seven is going to be the Police Department Manpower and Criminal Incident Report for April 2017.
Thank you, Mayor, City Council members. Congratulate our new mayor and our new council members. Look forward to working on each and every one of them. This is the report for April 2017. Got a total manpower of 16. They worked 2,686 hours. We answered 395 calls. Made a total of 81 arrests. They issued 114 traffic citations. They took in 128 reports. We worked a total of 11 accidents and answered 13 alarm calls. There's a breakdown of the other reports below there, and I'll answer any questions if you have them.
Number eight, consider and approve list of surplus items which are no longer serving any useful purpose for the city to be listed on the online auctioneer services from Renee Bates Auctioneers Incorporated are to be scrapped or destroyed. And the city administrator will explain the list.
Council members, we have in the back of your packet, I have a list of items that have been accrued over the years from the police department. They're currently in a building that we have out at Public Works, secured in there, and it's taken up quite a bit of room that we're needing to store some supplies and inventory for the Public Works Department. The police department has identified all of these as items that they can no longer use. They're no longer service to them, and so we'd like to go through the proper procedures to be able to get rid of it and put it on the auctioneer website. If we receive no bids on those items, then we can take them in. Some of them are metal prisoner transport cages and the like. We can scrap those for at least for the metal.
Is there a motion that we accept this?
I'll make a motion to accept it.
Second.
Is there any discussion? Everyone in favor, show up. Sure. On to number nine, the presentation, discussion, and acceptance of the fiscal year 2016 audit. We just need to make a motion.
Oh, no. Go ahead. I don't have to talk. My name is Molly Abley. I'm audit partner at Axley & Rohde. We perform your independent outside third-party audit for you each year. You are required to have an audit. I believe yours is a requirement from your bonds that you hold. On page 3 of the document that you have in front of you, I'll just go through a couple of things. I know there's a lot of information here, so unless you just know of a question you have for those, we will talk about them. But on page 3, this tells the responsibilities of management, which is the council of the city, as well as the management here that works in the administration. You are responsible for the preparation of these financial statements. All the numbers that go into them are your numbers. We take them, we may tweak them just a little bit, but they are your numbers and you're responsible for them. Our responsibility is to express an opinion on them based on our audit. So we do some audit procedures and we go through those and we express an opinion. Our opinion this year is an unmodified opinion, which means it's the highest opinion we can give. It states that everything is presented fairly in all material respects. On page 7 of the bound report, just want to point out a few things here. This is the city's net position as a whole. It takes your governmental activities, which is your general fund, your debt service fund, your grant fund, as well as your business type activities, which is your water and sewer fund, and it compares them to prior year. But in total, on the last column there, your total net position for the year, both all your funds put together, is right at $11 million. That includes your assets. You know, you have physical assets in the city. We have debt that's taken out of that number as well. So all of those netted together is right out at $11 million. For the change from prior year of your net position, you increased your net position right at $1 million, almost $800,000 of that was in the governmental activities, your general fund activity, that's your day-to-day operations. A little over $350,000 was in your business service, which is your water and sewer activities for the year. On page 34 of the same bound report, this was your budget for the general fund for last year. Governmental entities work on a budget basis. For the most part, your budget had a positive variance of just over $200,000. You actually made some money. I know you just spoke of the auctioneers. You made some money on some assets that we got rid of for the year. Just over $300,000, so that kept your budget in a positive variance at the end of the year. We had a couple of departments that were over budgeted, and a couple of those things had to do with some leases we did not budget for, and that happened after the budget was originally created. We just didn't amend it. The other two letters that are separate from the bound report is just standard communications that we would have to report to you. The thicker of the two, if we had any issues, concerns, difficulties in performing the audit, we have to report that to you. And of course, we do not. Everything went well during the audit. On the back of that report are the adjustments we made. We didn't do anything unusual or too significant. A lot of things were just we capitalized some items and moved some things around and reclassed them, but nothing unusual or out of the ordinary from prior year if you were here then. The other letter, some more standard communication. We do have to communicate to you, since you are the governing council, that anytime we have a segregation of duties issue in the administration, that you are the overseer. You are supposed to be keeping up with what administration is doing, reviewing, approving, and we know in the minutes that you're doing that. But just the fact that we have that, we have to report that to you each year to remember to be cognizant of that and keep reviewing and keep asking questions. That's the best way to do. And I know it's a lot of information, but if you do have any questions, we can go over it. And of course, if you have any questions, if you get to looking at it, they do know they have my phone number. So.
On to item 10, we're fixing to adjourn, and we're going to have refreshment. And my pastor is here, and I would like for him to pray over before we start the reception, and pray for us to have a wonderful team here that's really going to work together. Oh, yes, sir.
There was something in our package that y'all just gave, and I want to address it. And that is, it's dealing with employees, so I'd like to see that on our next council meeting and discuss what's the situation about this, without calling any names.
Okay.
Press it to the mercy of...
And that, right after the prayer, I would like to call the exiting mayor and two council members. We, on behalf of the city, have a plaque of appreciation that we would like to present them right before the refreshment.
Lord, we are here tonight to say thank you for Joni and these council members and their desire to serve this community as our newly elected mayor and our council people. We ask that you give them wisdom and ability to do this job. Lord, we thank you for Joni's heart to make a difference in Crockett and work together with all of us to bring about needed change and advancement. Lord, we appreciate all the people who serve and sacrifice daily and give themselves to this community cheerfully to help it grow and become a city that inspires other cities. We realize many of those who serve go unnoticed or unrecognized, but they give of themselves anyway. Lord, we realize that Joni and the team here in Crockett have some real problems to face, and that some of them can only be resolved by new investment, new energy, and new vision. And we truly believe that those people are in place in this city, ready and willing to open the door to a new future and renew hope. Jesus, we give you honor and thanks for allowing us to live in such a great nation and to have this wonderful community in which to grow and love together. It is only with your help and guidance that we will truly make today and tomorrow beautiful here in Crockett. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Amen. I'll maybe be seated and I'll present those plaques. I guess what I'll do is just read the plaque. Both of the council members, they both say the same, so I'd like to read that on behalf of the city to exiting council member Ray Bruner and council member Ms. Julian. As fire chief and now as city manager, it's been a privilege to serve under you, under your guidance and your wisdom. I thank you for your service to this city. I know it hasn't been all fun, but you have done it in a manner that Crockett is better off now that having served everything. So I appreciate it. In appreciation for your hard work and dedicated service on behalf of the City of Crockett, Precinct 2, this plaque is presented with deepest appreciation to Mr. Ray Bruner. In appreciation for your hard work and dedicated service on behalf of the citizens of City of Crockett, Precinct 1, this plaque is presented with deepest appreciation to Ms. Jeannie Julian. I couldn't talk her into giving your other gavel, so we found one.
I broke one.
With deep appreciation for your generous commitment of time, support, visionary guidance, and for your undaunting leadership to the City of Crockett staff and citizens, Mr. Robert Mayer.
Thank you.
I believe that's all. We don't want to start crying.
Thank you all for coming, Mayor Robertson.